no hay para plomba.
Welcome back, everybody, to the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships from Solleftea, Sweden. Sverige. My name is Randy Ferguson. It's great to have you back as the world has joined us once again live on the web. We are going once again live on the web today, and we are going now into our semifinals. And we had some very interesting qualification rounds this morning. And now it's time for the head-to-head battles. And we'll be starting with our sit ski. And Romero Zik, Ivan Goncharov, Roman Petushkov, Grigory Mirugin, Mihailo Chachenko, and Sergei Kaizanyak will be our first skiers on course in our semi-final heat number one. Voilà la demi-finale numéro 1. Et vous voyez le hold-back ici, c'est la pénalité en temps. Ou pas la pénalité, devrais-je dire, c'est le basé sur les classifications. C'est avec ces temps que partiront les athlètes. Et on les verra à l'instant. So once again, there we have our first sit skiers of this semi-final heat number 1. And the times to start will be Romero Zik first, 6 seconds back, Ivan Goncharov, 12 seconds back, Petushkov, Murigin, Shevchenko, and Kishniak, Sergei Kishniak will be starting 12 seconds back. This is based on their sporting class, once again, and we have within this group LW11 through 12. And that is the reason why they do not start all at the same time. Everything is based on a time handicap in this heat section now. And there we are, right away, on screen, Romain Rosic à l'écran pour la France. Il sera le premier à partir, classe LW11, avec un avantage de 6 secondes, ou un avantage, on peut appeler ça une priorité basée sur sa classification. Et le voilà, fin prêt à commencer. And before we start, we'd like to say a big welcome to Maria Larsson, Minister for Children and the Elderly here for Sweden. And she will also be with us tonight for our award ceremonies that will be carried live on the web once again at Paralympic Sport TV. So a big welcome to Maria Larsson, Minister for the Children and the Elderly, with us here this afternoon. Already noon time here in Solleftea, Sweden. Svaria, as we get ready for our semifinal heats. And Romain Rosic is ready, getting the start here in semifinal heat number one, Sitski men. And then we'll have our semifinal heat, Sitski men number two. Randy Ferguson, an honor and a pleasure to be with you all here today in Sweden for these 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships in Solleftea, Sweden. It is that time of year. Nordic Championships also happening in Val di Fiemme, Italy. Amazing skiing there on that side. And Romain Rosic is now on course. And in 6 seconds, Ivan Goncharov will take off. There he goes. So Ivan Goncharov chasing down Romain Rosic. And in a few seconds, there we go. Our final competitors, Petushkov, Murigin, Chachenko, Kishniak, are all on course. And now it is a question of crossing the line first to make it to the finals. And three of these men will be doing that. And here we are. We are on course. And there's the battle live in the stadium here in Solleftea. Will Rosic be able to keep his distance with the group? Now through this very, very tricky scrub area and down the descent. This is a 900-meter course, and you'll see them there disappear under the tunnel, and a very tricky turn here. The groomers having to do a lot of work to keep our athletes safe around that descent and corner. So Rosic choosing to stay out of the inner track as he is now being chased down by bib number one, Roman Petushkov of Russia. The beautiful view here on our monitor of the city of Solleftea in the valley. Hostelverget Hotel there in the background. And Rosic trying to fend off now the impending attack of Petushkov, but still in the mix here, Goncharov, Mirugin from the Ukraine, and coming up now, Mirugin, I'm sorry, of Russia, but Chachenko of the Ukraine off the back, and Romain Rosic still in the running, Kishniak, also from the Ukraine in this group. And the Russian coaches cheering on their group here as now the Russian duo has taken the lead here. As they come back into the stadium, up that climb portion of the course. Very strong, stable pushes. The upper body strength, the shoulder area is what has to be used. You don't want to be moving the trunk too much as that destabilizes the sit ski. So there we are in the lead right now. Petushkov, Mirugin of Russia, Petushkov looking over his shoulder. Still in the mix is the Ukraine's Sergei. Oh no, this is Mikhailo Chachenko. And there we are, crossing the line in first and second will be Petushkov and Murugin. As they are the two first skiers over the line. And once our full gamut of starters has passed the line, we will have our results showing who will make it here to the final. But definitely looking very strong here in this group, Petushkov and Murugin. So then wearing number one, Roman Petushkov. He was fifth in Vancouver, wanting to best that ranking at home in Sochi next year for sure. Leader of the overall right now in the sitski category. And we'll be moving over to semifinal heat number two. And in this group, we will have another six skiers. And right there, wearing the colors of the Ukraine, he'll be our first skier out, number 11. This will be Yuri Kostchuk from the Ukraine. And he's one of the top contenders here today with four Paralympic medals. However, more of a middle to long distance skier. Has done pretty good in some short distances in the biathlon. However, we'll see if Kostchuk has it in him to sprint. Maybe just a warm-up for him here this week. And we saw him clock the 11th best time in the qualifications. LW 10.5 skier, 3:27.31 was his time. Waiting for the countdown here is...
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Yuri Kostchuk is now on course, but watch out. He has to contend against Martin Flag of Germany, who will start with a 15-second time lap. There he goes. And now in about 6 seconds, the rest of the group will be taking off with Ilalutdinov first. Also in that group will be Luki Januinka from Belarus, Trygve Steinar Larsen from Norway, and also in that group from Belarus, Dmitry Laban. And they are off and chasing down our two front runners, Kostchuk and Flag. So as you can understand, Kostchuk and Flag more affected by their disabilities, classed as a 10.5 is Kostchuk, and Flag an 11.5. Ilalutdinov and Luki Janenka, Larsen and Laban, all LW12s. So the least impaired by their disabilities, hence the time difference at the start. So you can just see the power here as we have on our screen, the climb out of that very, very tricky tunnel. And now the group coming up behind, so it is a Flag right there with Ilalutdinov, and not very far behind are Luki Janenka, Larsen and Laban. Laban bringing up the rear there in that group. Dmitry Laban was seventh in Vancouver. And right now in the IPC rankings, he sits 15th. Now the lead is the man who was wearing the red bib in qualifications from Russia, Ramil Ilalutdinov. Martin Flagg right there. But the world champ from 2011, Tygve Steinar Larsen from Norway, now really putting on the pressure, wearing it here, bib number 7. He will be the fourth skier maybe through here. We'll see, because right now we have coming up on the back one of the Belarusians. Who will it be? Is it Lukianenka? But definitely in the lead right now, Ramil Ilalutdinov from Russia. Tygve Steinar Larsen, the 2011 champ, now in this climb, passing Flag, that he's going to have an immense challenge by one of the Belarusians here. And it looks to be, from our vantage point, number 3, it is Yevgeny Lukianenka, who's going very strong, passing Flag, and now challenging Tygve Steinar Larsen. And also slowly now coming around the bend, and he's preoccupied, and I would be too, because barreling down on him is Larsen and Lukianenka, but I think he will have it in him today to make it to the finals. This is Ramil Ilalutdinov from Russia. Alors le Russe qui s'amènera en finale. Et oh, look at this finish here. It's going to be a second place for Yevgeny Lukianenka of Belarus. Oh, a surprise, as we do not have the presence of the 2011 champ, Steinar Larsen. Wow, surprise, surprise. There we go. That's the way it goes, my friends, as sometimes we end up with some surprises in the finals. And let's give a big round of applause as Yuri Kostchuk will be making his way to the finish line in this second semifinal Sitski men. And we have on our screen the replays of that second semifinal. And the moment where Ramil Ilalutdinov placed his attack on the climb, and it was a question of managing his effort as he made his way to the finish line. Wow, so we do have a qualifying. We have Petushkov, Ilalutdinov, Lukianenka, Mirugin, Larsen, and also joining the sextet for our final later today will be from the Ukraine. This will be Mykhailo Kachenka. He will be part of our 6 in the finals for our Sitski later on this afternoon. Alors voilà, les skieurs qualifiés, Ilalutdinov, Lukianenka, Larsen, le champion du monde 2011, world champ in 2011, Flag, Laban, and Kostchuk. C'était les résultats de cette dernière demi-finale, et les 3 premiers se qualifient pour la grande finale. So that was the result from our second semifinal. Top 3 moving to the final later on today. And now we are going to be going to our women's Sitski semifinal number 1. From Solleftea, Sweden. And in our first semi-final, we will have Ludmila Pavlenko from the Ukraine, who will start 7 seconds before Eovleva from Russia, Konovalova from Russia, and Martinsen from Norway. And we're off! Ludmila Pavlenko is our first skier out. And there go the 3 chasers in this women's Sitski semifinal number 1. Ludmila Pavlenko into this group, finishing just off the podium in Vancouver during the 2010 Paralympic Games. And now, very close behind, Marion Martinsson, bronze at the 2011 World Championships in this event. And the Norwegian has also taken part in three Paralympic Summer Games as a swimmer. So that upper body strength being utilized throughout the year. Summertime swimmer and wintertime competitor here. Maria Jovereva surprising a lot of people during the prologue as she clocked the best time of 3:54.74. And you just see the difficulty here in that turn on that descent for Pavlenko, fourth of the Winter Games. And coming up now, Jovereva, as we mentioned, best time in qualifying. Oh, unfortunately, there is contact on the climb here between Jovereva and it's Svetlana Konolavalova, the two skiers from Russia, looking for the same track just as they came out of the tunnel and were on the climb, which now profits Ludmila Pavlenko as she continues to lead here in this women's sit ski semifinal number one. And she's going strong now, able to relax a bit more as Marion Martinsson, the Norwegian. And Maria Jovereva. So back into the mix. Jovereva having a lot of trouble here getting into the track. But she's still going strong. Despite that crash, has picked up some time on Martinsson. So a newcomer here doing what she has to do for Russia. Maria Jovereva, as they will now start the climb, still in the lead. Ukraine's Ludmila Pavlenko wearing the bright neon green and black uniform. And now coming up with the green neon skirt and the Russian uniform, pulling with enormous amounts of strength now. She is a beautiful revelation here. Maria Jovereva from Russia now in the lead. Is Marion Martinsson, yes, still in third place is the Norwegian. Bronze medalist at the 2011 World Championships in this event. And still taking control. And right now, all that Pavlenko needs to do is to keep the pace and make it around this last corner and stay close to Maria Jovereva from Russia. She comes around the last bend, and this is the final straight. Being cheered on by the coaches and continuing her astounding performance. And she will lay off here. Maria Jovereva from Russia will be moving on to our women's final. Ludmila Pavlenko keeping up with her great performance, ending up in second. And it will be Marion Martinsson from Norway coming in third. So those ladies will be moving on. And we saw there the young Maria Jovereva explaining to her coach what had happened as she came into contact with her countrymate Svetlana Konovalova on the descent. And she is now into the stadium, into the final straight, and will be completing semifinal number one of the sit ski women's competition here in Solleftea, Sweden, on our first day of competition, a day of sprints. And very unhappy there is Konovalova, pardon me. And asking her teammate there, Jovereva, what happened on that descent. So now to a semi-final heat number two. We will have coming up very soon our four next skiers in this women's sit ski as we on the web show that crash between the two Russian skiers. And it looks to be like Konovalova, who ran into some problems in the track area at the top of the climb, however, did not really hinder Maria Ivoleva's performance as she came barreling back into this competition and on the final ascent here coming into the stadium, took possession of first place and never looked back after that here in Solleftea in the women's semifinal heat number one of two. And our second one coming up right now. We can expect some of the same action. So Maria Ivoleva, Ludmila Pavlenko, Marian Martinsen, Svetlana Konovalova are in that order for semi-final heat number one. Dans cet ordre pour la demi-finale numéro un. And we are just about to start now with our second semi-final sit ski women. And in this group we'll have LW 10.5 Germany's Deutschland's Anja Wicker. Also from there, Belarus LW 11 with an 11 second delay to start. It will be Ludmila Wojcik, as we just saw Anya Vika take off for Germany. Then 26 seconds behind will be Ukraine's Olena Yurkoskova and Marta Zenulina from Russia. And that is Olena Yurkovska for the Ukraine. 900 meters for these ladies, and they are off. So we just saw Yurkovska and Zelulina on course, and Yurkovska was the silver medalist in Vancouver. And oddly enough, not qualifying today was Paralympic champ Francesca Porcelato. Not making it to the semis here today. But a very different contingent of skiers as Paralympics going up a notch since the last games 3 years ago and 2 years ago since our last World Championships. New faces, new nations, serious training, and the Russian Armada really out and present for these World Championships, as we see on screen now in the descent, negotiating very well that descent. Anja Wicker from Germany, from Deutschland. L'Allemande qui maintenant va entamer la portion en descente de ce parcours. Some beautiful images from our friends here and the TV crew, all our cameramen sitting up as we see down in the valley. So the city of Solleftea. It's a two-up battle right now between Vicker and Ludmila Wojcik. And now there we have a visual on our screen here as Vicker still looking very strong on the climb. This is not going to be an easy one as they make their way back into the stadium. And now chasing very, very fast. That was Wojcik from Belarus. But she's going to have some company very soon as Yurkovska, the silver medalist from Vancouver, is making her way back into the mix. And so is Marta Zenulina. Has not said her last word, but there is definitely a battle there for that second place. As Anja Wicker being cheered on by her countrymates as she is back into the stadium here. Look at this battle, all four ladies still in the running here. Anja Wicker doing all she can to stay off the front. But here comes Olena Yurkovska in the climb, and they are moving away now from the rest of the group. This is but an example of what we'll be seeing in the finals very soon for the World Championship title. It is now Olena Yurkovska who has decided to take things in her hands and move to the front of this race. Still going very strong for Belarus is Ludmila Wojcik, who is just on the back of the skis of Anja Vicker right now from Germany. One last swooping turn, and here comes Olena Yurkovska to the finish line as she will consolidate her place in the finals later today, looking for another title in her very, very impressive bio. And there we are, over the line, Olena Yurkovska from the Ukraine is now into the finals. And following Wojcik, then Vicker in third place. And rounding up the group from Russia, Marta Zenulina. And given it all they had, very, very difficult course here in Solleftea. So one of the most decorated athletes in Paranordic history, back in another final, Olena Yurkovska, as we see on our screen here, the replay and the work done by Anja Vicker. She stayed away for a good three quarters of this course, if not more, but too much for her to contend with the power of the Ukrainian and great champion Yurkovska, as she ends up winning semifinal heat number two. And we'll have our official qualified skiers very soon for the finals. As you're watching the 2013 Nordic Skiing World Championships live from Solleftea, Sweden. So welcome everybody from Solleftea, Sverige, as 300 of the top Paranordic skiers in the world have met here in this beautiful country, beautiful area of the country, about 500 kilometers north of Stockholm. And an area known for forest industry, fishing, a lot of tourism. And we're staying here at the Hostel Bergette, a new complex offering biathlon, cross-country skiing, and also alpine skiing right here just over the town city of Solleftea in Sweden. First day of competition here. The sprints are on the menu of the day, and we will be then moving further into the week into our mid-distances, long distances, and next week competing here in the biathlon. The Nordic Skiing for Paris, for Paris skiing, once again, is cross-country skiing and also biathlon. So part of the same championships. And a big thank you goes out to our organizing committee, Elisabeth Bystrom and company, doing an amazing job in welcoming the world, 19 nations, over 300 athletes to Solleftea for this event. Held every 2 years. So remind you, you are watching live on the internet on the YouTube channel of Paralympic Sport TV. The 2013 Nordic Skiing World Championships, and a very crucial world championship this is. It's one of the last opportunities amongst para-Nordic skiers to go head-to-head at a high level. Yes, they will have the test event on the Paralympic Games, of course, in Sochi in a couple of weeks, but still vying for a very important title, the one of world champion here this week. So there we are, our qualified skiers, Anja Vicker, Ludmila Wojcik, Ludmila Pavlenko, Maria Ioleva, Olena Yorkovska, and Marianne Martinsen are qualified for our women's sit-ski final. Voilà donc les qualifiés, Vicker, Wojciech, Pavlenko, Ioleva, Yorkovska et Martinsen pour la finale chez les dames sit-ski. Now we'll be going to our men's sit-ski final, la finale chez les messieurs. And all LW class athletes, meaning that there will be no time difference at the start. These gentlemen will all start together. So here we are, our list of our starters. No holdback. Roman Petushkov, Ramil Ilalutdinov, Yohani Lukianenka, Grigory Murigin, Trygve Steinar Larsen for Norway. Our skiers being set up now in the start gate. So this is the moment they've all been waiting for. They've done the work. They've made it through the rounds, qualifying, semis, and now to the finals. And a big surprise here today. The decision of Erik Zaripov not to take part in this sprint event. And also the non-qualification of Paralympic champ Sergei Shilov. So very interesting, a new generation, a new group. The man leading this one here, Roman Petushkov, is the man who finished fifth in Vancouver. Also in this group, 2011 champ from the last World Championships. Trygve Larsen from Norway. We're almost ready for the start here as our athletes are set up. La grande finale, sit-ski, messieurs. And we are off. This is the sit-ski men's final. And once again, all skiers starting at the same time as they are all LW12 class skiers. And already the Russians moving off the front. Trygve Steinar Larsen is going to have his work cut out for him here today if he wants to hope to repeat his performance from 2 years ago. He's going to have to fend off Roman Petushkov and Ramil Ilalutdinov from Russia. Petushkov and Ilalutdinov, the top two men on the IPC ranking in this event. And there they are with about a 2 to 3 second lead as they make their way into the tunnel. A very tricky part of this course as they go under the tunnel here is a very sharp turn. You see them leaning into the inside. It is once again wearing bib number one, Roman Petushkov of Russia. Bib number two, Ramil Ilalutdinov of Russia. Yohani Lukianenka from Belarus wearing bib number three. From Russia also wearing bib number five, Grigory Murigin. And world champ from 2011 wearing bib number seven is Trygve Steinar Larsen. And rounding up the sextet here, Ukraine's Mykhailo Chakchenko is number 8. But this is all about Petushkov and Ilalutdinov right now as they are moving away from the group. And what about... Oh, no! Going down is Ramil Ilalutdinov at a very, very bad spot for him on the climb. Whoa, that could cost him. And here comes Trygve Steinar Larsen. And not giving up here is Grigory Mirugin, who had a great semifinal. What a battle this is turning out to be here in this men's sit ski final. As they come into the stadium, look at that battle for second place. Three skiers in the running right now. Oh me, oh my. But this is Roman Petushkov trying to stay focused and concentrated. A last little climb section here. The Russians still 1, 2, 3. Will we have a Russian sweep here today? And Solleftea not giving up is Trygve Larsen from Norway. Oh! But this one has the colors of Roman Petushkov written all over them. But will the Norwegian, or Norjas, Trygve Steinar Larsen have it in him to make it here? Here he comes to the finale, looking for a world championship is none other than Russia's Roman Petushkov. And look at the race here. It will be a Russian sweep within second place. Ramil Ilalutdinov and a great finish here by Grigory Mirugin from Russia. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 ici pour les Russes aujourd'hui à Solleftea. Et il a tout donné. Trygve Steinar Larsen giving it all he had to make it to the podium, but today it is Russia 1, Russia 2, and Russia 3 in Solleftea. What a performance, and please give it up. Still in the race, coming here is Mykhailo Chashenko from the Ukraine, completing our group in the men's sit ski final. What a race, and really having to motor there. Ramil Ilalutdinov, as he was almost trying to pass Petushkov in the climb, losing his balance, falling off, but a very happy man, Roman Petushkov of Russia. And we see here on our screen for the webcast for our friends watching around the world, that amazing descent by the two Russian skiers. They were going neck and neck here, and unfortunately, catching an edge was Ramil Ilalutdinov. That cost him precious, precious time because he was coming up on Roman Petushkov. But in the end, Petushkov, the strongest of the group and world champion of the men's sit ski sprint class. We will now be moving very soon to our women's sit ski group as Russia is getting ready to celebrate here tonight. And just a reminder for those of you here with us in Solleftea and on the web, that will be going live as of about 10 minutes to 7 Solleftea's time. So wherever you are in the world, check the time difference, and we will be there with you with our award ceremonies. Donc, mesdames et messieurs, on vous invite dès 19h, heure de Solleftea, en direct sur le site YouTube Paralympic Sport TV pour nos cérémonies protocolaires qui auront lieu à 19h ce soir, heure de Solleftea, ou l'heure de la Suède. So what a race once again by the Russian team. 1, 2, 3, a clear sweep for them in the men's sit ski final of the World Championships. Now coming up very soon will be our women's the group, and we will then move on to our standing men, standing women, and completing our day of racing here with our men's semifinals, and then into our women's final, and also our men's final at the first day of the IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships. And we are in live from Solleftea, Sweden. Welcome, one and all, if you're just joining us for these final heats. It's a great pleasure to be with you here on a beautiful day. And there we are, official results. World champion Roman Petushkov, Ramil Ilalutdinov is a silver medalist, and Grigory Murigin bringing up the rear on the podium. Top three that we will honor tonight here in Sweden. So yes, it's our first day of competition, a beautiful day here, a bit windy on certain sections, but a balmy 0 degrees Celsius without the wind chill. So the snow at about the same temperature. And we are looking at pretty much the same scenario all week. So if you're joining us from the United States of America, unfortunately no North Americans in our final rounds this afternoon. Quite surprising, but we will see them throughout the week. And we are looking at, as I was saying, the same type of weather pretty much throughout the week. Temperatures are hovering around the 30 to 35 degree Fahrenheit, 0 to about plus 3, plus 5 Celsius. As we now will be setting up with our women in the Sitski final. And in this group, right there starting off, class LW10.5, so there will be time differences starts for Deutschland, Germany, Anja Wicker. For Belarus, LW11, starting 11 seconds behind, will be Ludmila Wojcik. Oh, this time for the Ukraine, LW11.5, starting 19 seconds behind, we'll have Ludmila Pavlenko. Then we'll have three LW12 skiers in Maria Yovoleva, Olena Yorkovska, the great Paralympian, and Marian Martinsson, the bronze medalist from 2011 in this event. Let's see what she'll be able to do here. Also winning a bronze in the 5K during those championships. And a top Paralympic swimmer for Norway, Marion Martinsson, getting ready. But the story of the day in this women's category is, there we go, Anja Wicker starts the action here in the women's sprint event. Sitski off right away. Ludmila Wojcik. In 8 seconds, we'll have Ludmila Pavlenko from Ukraine taking off. There she goes. And now the next three skiers will be going together. Yovaleva, the story of the day right now, despite a crash, making it into the finals. And she had the best qualifying time early on today. Olena Yurkovska, the great Paralympian, one of the most decorated Paralympians of all time. And Marian Martinsson for Norway. Noria making her way here into the group. So here we go, 900 meters to complete, and the story will be told for these ladies in this women's sitski final. Anja Wicker doing amazingly well in her semi-final heat as she fended off the attacking group behind her and making it into the final here this afternoon, down through the tunnel coming around. Athletes have now mastered that portion of the course. Watching them train the other day, very, very difficult through there. But our groomers are doing an amazing job to keep them on course and safe today. Coming through now, Wojcik for Belarus, as she climbs the power needed for these sit skiers up through there. Deciding to stay out of the tracks is Wojcik as she goes from left to right. But closing in now, Yovaleva Also, Jurkowska Martinsson in that group. They are coming fast. Pavlenko also. And from the image on our screen here, seen by the whole world, Anya Vikel doing very well here. I think the competitors behind have gotten clogged up in a bit of traffic over the just before the descent in the climb. And now making her move is Maria Ivoleva from Russia. And coming up very fast, the great Olena Jurkowska in the black outfit there. However, not saying her last word is Marion Martinsson. Oh, a bit of a contact there between Jurkowska and Martinsson. Jovaleva going strong, being cheered on by her coaches. We see Goldie up there giving her the go, 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 go. Oh, this is far from over here. Does Anya Vikel have it in her to take this one to the line? But here comes Maria Ivoleva and also Marion Martinsson. Oh, Vikel being chased down now. And the new star of this event, Maria Ivoleva, is making her way to the front, attacking exactly where she did in the semifinals and passing right now Anya Vikel. Oh, what a race here for Ivoleva. And now coming fast, bronze medalist from 2011, Marion Martinsson. And right where she attacked once again and accelerated in the semifinals, Olena Jurkowska looking for another title to add to her trophy cabinet today. The Ukrainian motoring now. She has been more of a distance skier, and this one is gonna be all about Maria Ivoleva of Russia, followed by Olena Jurkowska, and ending up in third today from Norway, Marion Martinsson, Anya Vikel. Right there in front of us, what a performance here as we welcome to the finish line also Ludmila Pavlenko, number 28. And soon to come, completing the group will be from Belarus, Ludmila Wojcik. But what a performance here by the young Maria Ivoleva from Russia. Congratulations on her victory here today. Very, very strong, as let's applaud Ludmila Wojcik completing our women's final group. And Maria, very happy and with reason here as we wait for the official results. What a performance here today by Maria Ivoleva, as we will see on our internet broadcast to start. And the contact here between Jurkowska and Martinsson as they were really playing it close there in the finale. The moment where Ivoleva made her move, sensing that Jurkowska and Martinsson were up to something behind, and bringing it home for Russia. Another medal here for them. Maria Ivoleva is world champion of the women's sit ski LW 10 through 12. So congratulations to her. Alors, championne du monde chez les sit ski femmes, classe LW 10 à 12 de la Russie, Maria Ivoleva. Prenant la médaille d'argent, Olena Jurkowska. Et la médaille de bronze de la Norvège, Marion Martinsson. Once again, we invite you, everybody, tonight, 7 o'clock, Sweden time, to the Solleftea Hallstatt Ski Station here for the award ceremonies. The Hallstatt Ski Station We'll have our award ceremonies not only live here, but live on the web. The World Wide Web will be showing our award ceremonies tonight directly from Solleftea. Once again, welcome everybody to the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships. Mesdames et messieurs, bienvenue à cette web diffusion des championnats du monde paranordique IPC 2013 en direct de Solleftea en Suède. So welcome to Svalia. Solleftea, Svalia, as we will go now to our semifinals for our men's standing. So that will be classes LW2 through 9. And in our first group, we'll see a skier from Finland, two Russians, two Ukrainians, and, pardon me, a Norwegian in that group. Six skiers taking part in our semifinal number one on this first day of competition in Solleftea. Sprints today. And we will end things with our blind visually impaired classes, as we'll have our men's semifinals coming up, then our women's final and men's final later in the day here. So temperature once again, about with the wind, about -3 degrees Celsius. That is with the wind. And we are looking for about the same type of temperature all week here in Solleftea. So making the groomer's job pretty difficult, having to wait for the late hours or early hours of the morning for grooming. And that will be happening later today. Or later during the night for our crew here. They've done a fantastic job, and we'd like to thank them very much for the amazing work and the time they've spent. As we mentioned earlier on in our broadcast, beautiful snow over the last few weeks here in this part of Sweden. Blistering cold, minus 28, minus 30 last week, and the temperature rising really fast, so it wreaks a lot of havoc on the upkeep of the course. Takes a lot of work, timing and precision, but experienced people here in Solleftea. So stay with us, everybody. We're going to take a short break here, and we'll be back with our semifinals for our standing men classes here in Solleftea, Sweden, for the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships. Just a reminder, everybody, we are live from Solleftea, Sweden, as we will be starting our event at 1 o'clock today. It's Sweden time, so that's in about 5 minutes. Stay with us. We will have our men's standing semifinal number one coming up in about 5 minutes. Restez des nôtres, mesdames et messieurs. Nous allons débuter dans à peu près 5 minutes notre demi-finale pour les messieurs standing, alors debout. Et ce sera pour les classes sportives LW 2 à 9 en direct de Solleftea en Suède. Hello? So everybody, here we go. We are ready for our first semifinal. Standing men, LW 2 through 9 are the sports classes. We will have in this first semifinal from Finland, Ika Toimisto. Then we'll have from the Ukraine, Igor Reptyuk. From Russia, Rushan Minegulov. Also from Russia, Ivan Kodlozerov. From the Ukraine, Vladislav Maestrenko. And rounding up this first semifinal group, starting with a 14-second deficit, will be LW4. This is Norway's Vegard Dahle. So there we are, everybody, setting up our first semifinal. Skiers are in the start lanes. And green will soon mean go for these athletes. Three top skiers making it through to the final. And we'll see who is in contention for a world title. So in this group, the silver medalist from Finland at the Paralympic Games. You saw him there right now. Ika Toimisto. Alors, tout juste là, le numéro 44, médaillé de bronze de cette épreuve lors des Jeux paralympiques, dis-je bien, de Vancouver. So, lining up, once again, number 44, Toimisto. Reptyuk at number 45. Minegulov, 48. Kodlozerov, 49. Maestrenko, 52. And Dahle, 41, 41. 20 secondes. 10 secondes du départ. 10 seconds from the start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! There we go. We are off. And a blistering pay. Oh! Unfortunately here, a trip up and a slip for Igor Reptyuk. There we are off the front. Our group now. And this is going to be a close one. And once again, Toimisto. And we just had the start for Vegard Dahle, who is now in that group, taking off with a 14-second deficit once again. Well, this is going to be a close one as these gentlemen are now up and over the crest. It is a four-up battle, and here comes Vegard Dahle from Norway. Will they be able to hold on here as they make their way now into the bottom portion of this stadium, used by the standing and visually impaired, not used by the Siski? We are now onto a 1.125 kilometer course, and in the lead, charging now, Ika Tuomisto from Finland. But watch out, here comes with a lot of power, Rushan Minegulov. And right on their heels is Ivan Kozlotserov of Russia. Vegard Dahle now just joining the group. Once again, being of a different sports class, LW4 compared to LW8 for the five other competitors. He started with a 14-second deficit, but he is now back in the group. Hence the reason why Tuomisto, Retioka, Minigelov, and Kozlotserov, really gave it all they had from the start. And Mestrenko also in that group, trying to fend off Dahle's attack, but impossible. There goes Vegard Dahle. He is now in the lead, picking up rapidly few seconds of deficit, looking very strong as he motors away. Now it will be a battle for the silver medal. But not saying his last word is Rushan Minegulov. Tuomisto also in that group. And Ivan Kozlotserov. But Vegard Dahle now moving away, keeping himself at a safe distance. And this is a very critical portion of the course as they've just climbed the most steep part. They will go on to a small flat here, make their way into the stadium, a last little ascent, and then it is all the way to the finish line. But this is gonna be a battle of wits and strength for the silver medal as we see Vegard Dahle from Norway. Noria moving away now, double pulling it here into the stadium. And the battle right behind there for the silver medal, as Vegard Dahle looking strong, coming through the scrub as he will make his way into the final tracks. And it looks like a world championship performance. Oh, getting tangled is Tuomisto behind, but it's going to be Vegard Dahle from Norway, world champion, coming in a second. Right behind will be Rushan Minegulov, and our bronze medalist once again from Finland, Suomi Ika Tuomisto. So there we go, our top three in this first semifinal. They will be going once again into the final for a world championship title. Vegard Dahle looking for another medal for his cabinet. So Dahle qualified, Minegulov qualified, unofficially at this point, and Ika Tuomisto third, where he ended up in Vancouver a few years ago. But still, another kick at the can, another chance for him later on in the final. As our first men's standing semifinal is completed. So back with our web audience to the replay. A strong start, but a trip up there by Ihor Reptiok. And then Ika Tuomisto taking control of things and trying to fend off here the impending arrival of Vegard Dahle from Norway. So Dahle right there looking for a spot to a battle for world champion later on today. He is now into the finals. And another trip up here at the end, as we see on the replay of Ivan Kozlov. So a few skiers going down in this event. A lot of pressure. That's what happens when the skiers are pushing themselves. And as the fatigue sets in, so official Dale Minegulov Tuomisto will be going to the final later on this afternoon. As we get ready now for semifinal number two, we will have LW6 skiers from Russia, Lekomtsev, Mark Arenz from Canada, from Russia, Alexander Yaremchuk, from Russia, Oleg Balukto, de la France, LW2, c'est Benjamin Davier, and from Russia, LW4, Kirill Mikhailov, who'll be starting with a 17-second holdback, 6 seconds for Davier, and the first four skiers will be taking off as LW6 all together here. Second semifinal, who will be in the finals later on, joining Dale Minegulov and Tuomisto, already qualified here. Alors, lesquels de ces trois messieurs se retrouveront en grande finale avec Dale Minegulov, Tuomisto un peu plus tard aujourd'hui. And here we go. There it is, the start, and a blistering one once again by the Russian skiers, and running into some issues there. It looks to be Alexander Yaremchuk. Mark Arenz with the red and white of Canada, number 42 there. Kirill Mikhailov taking off with a 17 seconds deficit. Oh, all over the place right now is Alexander Yaremchuk. Yaremchuk avec beaucoup de difficultés. S'en venant rapidement, Benjamin Davier. And the LW4 skier leaving 17 seconds behind the group. Kirill Mikhailov on his way. Will try to join the group as fast as possible. Silver medalist in Vancouver in 2010. As they are now on the descent, taking the lead is Vladislav Lekomtsev. But having it to fend off now, Alexander Yaremchuk with an enormous amount of difficulties from the start. Mark Arenz from Canada still in the mix. And already we saw Benjamin Davier from France making it back to the front of the group. Wow, swooping turn here by one of the Russian skiers. They are one and two and three. So right there, Vladislav Lekomtsev is leading, followed by Oleg Balukto. In third, looking to be like Yaremchuk. So Lekomtsev, followed by Balukto, Oleg Balukto. In second, we are down in the lower portion of this stadium here. Two levels, biathlon up top where we start and finish. Cross-country ski down the bottom here, just near the Hostel Berget, where we are officially received as official hotel. But Vladislav Lekomtsev looking for a place in the final. Oleg Balukto, his countrymate too. But now it is a three-up battle for the final spot for the finals here with Benjamin Davier qui travaille de façon acharnée présentement pour se trouver en finale. Mais il est déjoué par le numéro 42, Kirill Mikhailov, le médaillé d'argent de Vancouver. So the silver medalist from Vancouver now back in the mix, joining his two countrymates here. May even make his way to the lead as Alexander Yaremchuk with three or four spills at the start of this race, now starting to fail. Lemchenko here not seeming to have the best skis right now. The glide, but difficult conditions midday. And a very sticky situation snow-wise. Temperatures once again around the 32 degree Fahrenheit, 30 degrees Celsius mark. So Russia, one, two, and still three, but watch out. We have Benjamin Davier from France who is garnering lots of speed here on the climb, but will he have enough snow to make it to one of the top three spots here and hope to make his way into the final? As now it is Kirill Mikhailov who is off the front, followed by Oleg Balukto in the second. And it is, pardon me, still a Vladislav Lekomtsev that we missed on the screen there. Kirill Mikhailov right behind. So it's going to be 1-2-3 moving to the finals with Vladislav Lekomtsev. He will be followed by Kirill Mikhailov right there, number 42. And in third spot will be Oleg Balutko, followed by Benjamin Davier from France, de la France. And that will be Alexander Yaremchuk will be happy that this semi-final is over. And rounding up the group will be Canada's Mark Arends from Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island in the second semi-final. There we are. We have our finalists. They will be officialized very soon. And we'll be showing that to you. And we will... see the finals coming up today as we on the web will watch the replay. A very fast start by the Russians, a slip up for Yaremchuk, a first of many unfortunately for him. And it was Vladislav Lekomtsev who kept the lead from the start all the way through the end, but he knew very well that Kirill Mikhailov, the silver medalist from Vancouver, would be hot on his tracks, which is and was the case. So crossing the line first will be Vladislav Lekomtsev, Kirill Mikhailov, and Oleg Balukto. 1-2-3 Russia again. The Russians out in force here. They are firing some warning shots in regards to Sochi. Just under a year to that event. So Lekomtsev, Balukto, Tomisto from Finland, Minegalov from Russia, Dale from Norway, and Mikhailov from Russia will be our six finalists. Voilà les six finalistes pour la finale chez les hommes LW2NF standing men's final six now on the board. So stay with us, everybody. We will be going into our finals very soon. And that should be happening in a few minutes' time, as we'll see here our start lists for our LW women. First semifinals, and we'll have Yulia. There we go, the start, and we'll have Yulia Batenkova from the Ukraine taking off LW6 right in front of Shoko Ota from Japan, followed by Anna Milenina, Maya Yarvela, Irina Bui, and Ludmila Lyashenko, all LW8. Class skiers. Yulia Batenkova, for the Ukraine, the only LW6 in this first of two women's standing semifinals. top three make it to the finals later on today. The men just completed their semifinal round. So who will it be in the women's final? Once again, this is the first day of the IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships 2013 from Solleftea, Sweden. Thank you for joining us on the internet. Thank you for joining us here at the Halstad Ski Station in Solleftea, Sweden, and at the biathlon and cross-country skiing stadiums for this first day of competition. And it is 2 weeks of amazing action to come here, as we have this week the cross-country skiing, and next week it will be, for everyone almost involved, the biathlon events, part of the Nordic Skiing World for Paralympians and para-athletes. So in this start, hoping to make her way into the final, is the silver medalist from Vancouver Paralympic Games, from Japan, Shoko Ota. The Olympic champion will be in the next, the Paralympic champion, I'm sorry, will be in the next heat, Kononova. But right now, it's a fast affair, as the athletes are in the bottom portion of the stadium. And the silver medalist from the Paralympic Games, oh, as we've had a fall here, it looks to be like Yulia Betenkova going down, or no, it was Irina Bui, her teammate. But in the lead, silver medalist from Vancouver, Japan's Shoko Ota. Second is Yulia Betenkova. Third right now, Anna Milenina. Then we're looking at Finland's Maija Järvelä. So Maija Järvelä for Suomi, Finland. But they are now looking at the bib number of Shoko Ota. Ski away from them. And the top three only will be making it to the finals here today. So for those not involved in this two-up race between Ota and Betenkova, it's time to move. Semi-final standing women, number one of two in the sprint. Whoa, just saw Ota there slipping oh so slightly on the climb. Yulia Betenkova of Ukraine seems to be closing in and still skiing strong. Anna Milanina from Russia. And a good performance here by Yulia Betenkova, who's of a stronger disability class, LW6. And oh, struggling a tad here on the climb is Betenkova. And now it is a beautiful acceleration here by Finnish skier Maija Järvelä, as she is passed Anna Milenina from Russia. But still in the lead, Shoko Ota, as she'll make her way into the stadium. Hanging on strong, LW6 gear, Yulia Betenkova. And she looks like she may even be gaining some ground on Shoko Ota. You might want to be keeping some reserves for the final, because it looks like it's going to be a trip for Yulia Betenkova to the final round. And still in third, I think we now have a view. Yes, it is Maija Järvelä from Suomi, from Finland. As behind her, Milenina, the Russian, having a lot of slippage issue. I don't think her kick wax is very good right now. She seems to be struggling there. But Shoko Ota, Betenkova, and Järvelä from Finland still going strong. And it looks like those will be the three ladies that will make their way to the finals later on today from this women's standing semifinal heat number one. Coming up will be semifinal heat number two. Six other skiers vying for a spot in the finals later on. And look at this beautiful performance by these two ladies, Shoko Ota and Yulia Bentekova from the Ukraine. And they will be garnering a spot in the final later today. So getting their ticket to the finals. Once again, Shoko Ota, Yulia Bentekova. And in the third will be Maija Järvelä from Finland. Three more spots left as we see Anna Milenina coming into the stadium with Irina Bui. And there'll be one more skier to come around the bend, and that will be the Ukraine's Ludmila Yashenko completing semifinal heat number one. And for our friends in the internet world, a beautiful performance here by Yulia Bentekova as she took off with a 4-second advantage. Seemed to fade slightly towards the mid portion of this course, but did not want to have anything to do with the other skiers apart from Shoko Ota as she put the impetus on herself to make her way back up to the top and followed the pace of the silver medalist from Vancouver in 2010. So a beautiful performance, and we will be seeing those two ladies once again in the finals later today. So back to our start line, as we will now have semi-final number two getting underway for standing ladies. And in this group, we will have the lady who won the Paralympic title in Vancouver, Oleksandra Kononova, will be part of that group, and she is wearing bib number 63 today. So we'll be starting with LW6 skier from Japan, Yurika Abe. She'll be followed by the Ukraine's Oleksandra Kononova. As we saw, Yurika Abe taking off here. And then following Kononova out will be Bratyok from Russia and Kaufman also. And Belarus's Varona. And starting 4 seconds after them will be Zverya's, Sweden's own Elena Ripa, LW2 skier. And she is already off. And they are going to hunt down Yurika Abe. As three spots are only available for the final here today. And coming up very soon, we'll also have our visually impaired men's semifinals. Then our finals will be there for the ladies and for the men. And that will complete our day. Once again, a reminder for our team captains here on course. The team captains meeting will be at 5 p.m. today. 5 p.m. today. Alors, un rappel pour nos capitaines d'équipe, 17h aujourd'hui, la réunion des capitaines, 17h, so 5 p.m. And our award ceremonies, also live on the web tonight, will be at 7 p.m., 19h, les cérémonies protocolaires, en direct sur le web, dans le monde entier. Well, right now, going very strong, Natalia Bratyuk against Oleksandra Kononova of the Ukraine, yes, the Paralympic champion. And they have hot on their tracks also in that group. It look like Larisa Vorona from Belarus, Elena Ripa from Sweden, making her way back to the front group as we are peering down now with our video screens into the lower part of the stadium. It is still Yurika Abe. No, this is Oleksandra Kononova now, who has taken the lead as she has mastered this one. Larisa Varona from Belarus in second. And now in third is Yurika Abe from Japan. But coming fast now, the two Russians, Bratyuk and Kaufman. And soon to catch up with the group is Swede Elena Ripa. But the Paralympic champion, Oleksandra Kononova, not giving any respite to her competitors, even if this is but the semifinals. She is going for the maximum here throughout this event. It's going to be a very interesting final later today for these ladies. As we'll see once again, the top skiers in the world involved in our world championship battle. Oleksandra Kononova from the Ukraine, still looking strong, 3 years out from Vancouver, 1 year away from Sochi. Steady kick and glide for her, number 63. Skiing very well right now is Larisa Varona from Belarus. Fourth place in Vancouver behind Kononova Ota Burmistrova. That's Varona in fourth. And Aripa now on screen, being cheered on by the Swedish crowd here in Solleftea. Oh, beautiful battle up the front here. Is Kononova fading now or just leaving enough energy in the tank for the finals? I thought we'd see Larisa Varona from Belarus catch up to her. Slipping slightly on the climb, but seems to have better skis in the descent. And now, Elena Ripa from Sweden is the third skier in this group, means that she may get a ticket to the big final later on today. A lot of combination of leg power and arm power in on this course. Almost running right now is Larisa Varona from Belarus, as we see Oleksandra Kononova making her way into the stadium here in the lead. But now here comes Elena Ripa from Sweden, Sverige's own girl, now taking the lead. And Varona now looking like the one who is slightly fading. And yeah, Elena Ripa from Sweden now taking control of this women's standing second semi-final. Alors la deuxième demi-finale appartient présentement à la Suédoise Elena Ripa. LW2, elle est partie avec 8 secondes de déficit, starting with an 8-second deficit. Is Elena Ripa from Sverige, from Sweden, right there. She comes into the stadium, last few pushes here towards the line for Helene, and she will be making her way to the women's standing final later on today. For Sweden on home soil, Oleksandra Kononova from the Ukraine, and Larisa Varona also joining them in the final. So there we have our finalists in the women's standing classes. We will see them a little bit later on today in our next category to hit the tracks on the field. Will be our men coming up very soon. The A final standing men, or the final standing men at 1:30. So that's just about now. They are setting up in the starting area. We will now turn our attention to this final, as we see our replays on the internet. Oleksandra did the work she needed to do. Kononova struggling slightly maybe at the end, starting a bit early. And Elena Ripa from Sweden passing her as they entered the stadium. But importantly enough is that Alexandra Kononova is qualified with Ripa, and also joining them will be in that group Larisa Barona. So a top group selected for the women's standing final. Now we'll go to our men's standing final here, as we see officially on the board, Ripa, Kononova, and Varona qualified for the finals. And our men's standing final just about to start here, as we'll have Lekmotsev, number 43, Balukto, number 51, both from Russia. Tomisto, number 44, from Finland. Minegulov, from Russia, number 48. Dale, number 41, from Norway. And number 42, Russian Kirill Mikhailov, silver medalist in Vancouver. And there we are. We are off with our men's standing sprint final. And once again, some time differences here. As we mentioned, LW6s, Limotsev and Balukto taking off 3 seconds after LW8, Tuomisto and also Minigulov starting with a 3-second deficit. And they're going right now with a 17-second deficit. Vegard Dali and Kirill Mikhailov. Watch for these two gentlemen to battle it off here in this men's standing final. This is going to be an interesting one, as Lekomtsev taking off and starting where he left off during the qualifications and during our semifinals, leading the pack. And once again, we have in this group the silver medalist from Vancouver. He's wearing at number 44, Ika Tuomisto from Finland. And do not discount Vegard Dale. He was fourth just off the podium during that event. And also in this final, Kirill Mikhailov from Russia, silver medalist from that event. And there they go, the power. Now they are on the descent portion, taking them all the way down into the lower stadium area. This is the part of the course that our sit skiers did not complete, as they were doing 900 meters versus these gentlemen here and ladies doing 1.125Ks. So still going very strong. Lekomtsev, this young man, could cause a surprise. His countrymate Oleg Balukto right on his back. And now making a move on the outside. Orushan Minegulov. Ika Tuomisto right there in the group, number 44. And here come the two LW4 skiers, Vegard Dali and Kirill Mikhailov. And these three gentlemen can just feel those two others breathing down on their necks as they are trying to chase down Vladislav Lekomtsev, leading this race. Rushan Minegulov, maybe a 15-meter gap between Lekomtsev and Balukto. Minegulov, Tuomisto. Then we have Balukto, and double polling and looking at each other are Dali and Mikhailov. And here they come as they make their way into the steepest portion of this course. Oh, Tuomisto here having all sorts of issues as he's being passed. He looks like he was almost standing still. The Norwegian Vegard Dali moving right by him, getting caught behind Tuomisto. Now is Kirill Mikhailov from Russia, the silver medalist from the Paralympic Games of Vancouver. Still resisting these attacks is Vladislav Lekomtsev of Russia. And here they are back into the stadium. Can Lekomtsev keep up this pace. It's going to be hard. And double poling right now, like a madman on skis, is Vegard Dahle from Norway. His coach cheering him on. And Lekomsev not even looking back once, just doing his own thing here, concentrating, focusing on his race. But it looks like Vegard Dahle is going to have to pick up the pace here, because he may be running out of snow as they are coming around the last bend. Dahle right on the back of Lekomsev's skis. Are we going to see a sprint here? Which track will be chosen by Vladislav Lekomsev or Mr. Vegard Dahle? It is a two-up sprint. Here we go. Does Lekomsev have it in him? It's going to be close. It looks from our vantage point to be Vladislav Lekomsev from Russia just beating out Vegard Dahle of Norway. Hard to tell. And seeming to be in third place today, possibly Rushan Minegulov. But we'll wait for the photo finish call here. What a race by Lekomsev as he led throughout the race, which he did in the semifinals, fending off some skiers of different classes. But Vegard Dahle not leaving anything in the tank here in this men's standing final of the World Championships here in Solleftea, Sweden. Wow. As we go to our replay here on the board, looking, yes, it will be definitely Vladislav Lekomsev from Russia in an epic battle here with Vegard Dahle from Norway. So Russia and Norway once again, as they have many times, battling for gold here in the Nordic scene. And we're just waiting for our official results. And we'll be moving it to our next event. As on the web, looking at the replay here, Lekomsev from the start, powerful, steady and composed as he kept the lead, knowing very well that barreling down on him were his countrymate Mikhailov and the Norwegian Vegard Dahle. And it took a sprint to the end, which was won by Vladislav Lekomsev over Vegard Dahle. It is official now. And Rushan Minegulov of Russia winning the bronze in the men's standing category. So congratulations. Alors voilà, Lekomsev, Dahle, Minegulov, les trois médaillés aujourd'hui de cette classe sportive LW2-A9 chez les messieurs. Oh, a beautiful sprint to the end there. And that's what it's all about, folks. In these sprint events, 1.125 kilometers completed by the athletes. And we are now going to move into our next event, which will be our women's standing LW2 through 9 final. Alors, notre prochaine épreuve sera la finale LW2-A9 standing chez les femmes. Six skiers in this group and a very, very talented group here. A lot of experience. And we'll see who will come out on top as our world champion women's sprint standing here, as we will see the Paralympic champ, Kononova, also the silver medalist from that event, Shoko Ota from Japan, will also be involved in this race. Restez les nôtres. Stay with us, everybody. We are just about to start our next event. which is scheduled here for 1:41. Well, just about to get underway. Alors, nous sommes à quelques instants du départ. Alors voilà, c'est officiel, official. Lekomsev, Dale, Minegolov, our top three in our men's standing category, just being posted here. Now, all our attention is turned to the women's standing final of the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championship here in Solleftea, Sweden. Welcome one and all, everybody from around the globe joining us for this first day of competition of these World Championships. And we are live on www.youtube.com/Paralympic Sport TV. And it is great to be live with you all here today as we see the women getting ready. And this young lady here, quite a battle she put up in the semis, Yulia Batenkova, to stay and keep the pace of the silver medalist from the Paralympic Games from Japan, Shoko Ota. But now she'll have to fend off the attacks of the great Oleksandra Kononova. Maya Järvelä from Finland also in this final. Larisa Varona from Belarus. And the local favorite from Zvaria, from Sweden, Elena Ripa, will be part of this group here today. And there we are, green means go. So Yulia Batenkova is now off. Following her immediately is Oleksandra Kononova from the Ukraine, Shoko Ota from Japan, also Maya Järvelä from Finland, Larisa Varona from Belarus, and taking off as we speak is Sweden's Elena Ripa. So all the women are on course. This is the women's standing final here in these 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships sprint event. And a lot of talent out there on the course right now. We have two Paralympic medalists from the sprint events in 2010. And a lot of talent with local pride, Elena Ripa for Zvaria, for Sweden out there. Let's see if she will be able to repeat her performance from the semifinals, where she started with a pretty big deficit but made her way back to the front. And still going very strong, despite the fact that this is her third time around the course, is the Ukraine's Yulia Batenkova. Now breathing down on her neck is her countrymate, Oleksandra Kononova. And passing her right now, number 64, is Shoko Ota, with Kononova right there. Elena Ripa from Sweden making her way into the mix. Maya Järvelä, this is the tightest race we've seen yet. Very, very close now between these athletes in this women's standing final. As we now look to our TV monitor here in the booth, as they are going to make their way into the cross-country stamina. Oh, watch out, going off course now. Oh, bad luck here for Shoko Ota as she completely misses her turn. And it is Oleksandra Kononova now who is in the lead. So Ota going right off course. And now tripping up is Maya Järvelä. Oh, lots of changes here. Action happening in the lower part of the stadium. Confusion and crashes. Elena Ripa is still in third place. Elena Ripa from Sweden. And now having to do some damage control are Maya Järvelä and Shoko Ota from Japan, who literally went off course, had to come back a few meters to make her way back through the V-boards where she left the course. But now it's going to be a struggle for her to make it back to that lead group. Almost impossible at this point. And here they come up the last climb, and it is the Paralympic champion, Oleksandra Kononova from the Ukraine. About 10 meters behind her, Zvaria, Sweden's Elena Ripa, and Belarus's Larisa Varona. That is the trio now vying for the gold medal and world champion title. This is going to be interesting. And now Kononova having some difficulty on the climb. Getting some slippage here. Having to wishbone it a bit on the steepest portion. Aripa right behind her. Oh, imagine this, a world title for a Swede on home soil. The Swedes coming so close at the Nordic World Championships in Val di Fiemme. Maybe a para-Nordic victory for them here today in Solleftea. It's a three-way battle right now between Oleksandra Kononova, Larisa Varona now making it in, but it is Elena Ripa from Sweden that has taken the lead. There she is, making her way back into the stadium. Will this be golden glory for Zvaria here at home in Sweden? Will this be a golden moment as she is now pulling away from Kononova and Varona? Helene Ripa from Sweden in perfect control right now. Oh me, oh my. Tiring and fading is Paralympic champ Kononova. And moving away from her is Larisa Varona from Belarus. But this is going to be a magical moment for the Swedish skier as she has a few more meters to go and she will wear the title of world champion. The crowd making their way now to the finish line, cheering on the skier from Zvaria from Sweden. As she comes around, Elena Ripa, a magical moment in her career as a few more meters and she will be the world champion at home. There she is, she will cross the line and from Sweden, world champion, Elena Ripa. And Larisa Varona now making her way. She will win silver here today. And bronze medalist will be Oleksandra Kononova of the Ukraine, but the world champion and the story here today, ladies and gentlemen, from Zvaria is Elena Ripa as she is world champ of the women's standing class at home in Solleftea, Sweden. Quelle performance ici pour Elena Ripa alors qu'elle est couronnée championne du monde chez elle. En Suède. Whoa! As we now will be going into our men's line and visually impaired semifinal heat number one. For those of you watching on the internet, our replay here as we saw many changes at the front of the course. Of the group, I should say, on the course. And one of the major moments of that race, Shoko Oto going off course and staying out of trouble was Elena Ripa from Sweden, winning a world title at home here in the women's standing class. Fantastic, magical moment for Elena Ripa here at home. Now, our preview time start will be at 10 to 2, so any moment now, we'll have our first blind visually impaired semifinal. Once again, I remind you that we will be going to a format of four skiers here. So from 6 to 4. Now, we're doubling the number of athletes on course because we, in these visually impaired categories have the guides wearing the yellow bibs with the G on it. And we are just about to go. There we go. So our first skier out from Sweden and leader of the IPC rankings right now, Sebastian Modin. Right now we should have, in a few seconds, a pretty big lead there for B1 skier Sebastian Modin of 31 seconds on Anatoly Kovalevsky from Ukraine. There he goes right now. And he will be followed in 5 seconds by Oleg Ponomarev, and also leaving Yuri Utkin from Russia. So here we go. Two fastest skiers will make it to the finals. It is a 1.125 course, classic style. And welcome one and all joining us on the World Wide Web on the YouTube Paralympic Sport TV channel. We are live at the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships in Solleftea, Sweden. Our first day of competition, the sprints. Many championship titles have already been awarded here, or determined, I should say. They will be awarded this evening here, and watch on Paralympic TV also tonight at 7 p.m. Sweden time, as we'll have our award ceremonies going live there this afternoon. And we can hear Modin's guide giving him the directives here on the course. Albin Akarut. Or Akarut. And he will be telling him that the other skiers are slightly closing in now. And in that group, Oleg Ponomarev. And his guide also. And in that second group, Yuri Utkin from the Ukraine. And Modin fending off right now, looking very strong. And Modin, we will see him come back here into the stadium very soon. This is looking like a great performance. Good timing with his guide here. Ponomarev, right there on our screen, will be starting the ascension. Yes, as we see, double pulling it nonetheless up this steep, steep part of the course. And things are looking good for Sebastian Modin. Needs to be in the top two of this event, and he has kept his opponents at bay throughout this event. Oleg Ponomarev looking to be like his biggest threat right now in the semifinal heat of number one, blind and visually impaired men. Coming fast, looks like yes, it is Yuri Utkin. And coming into the stadium now, Sebastian Modin. And not much threat coming from his opponents. Are they keeping some energy in the tank here for the final? And that is Oleg Ponomarev. And we can hear Akarut, the guide for Modin, telling him, just push, you're into the tracks. And there we are. He will be qualified for the final. Another good performance by the Swedish skiers here today. Sebastian Morin coming over the line in semifinal heat number one for the blind and visually impaired men's group. And Oleg Ponomarev coming in second. So they will be the two skiers making their way into the final later today. Yuri Utkin, third of this group. And completing very soon will be Anatoly Kovalevsky, as he comes around the bend. Fourth in this first semifinal, the two top skiers advancing into the final. You know, it's great to see these athletes, even if they're not qualified, a smile on their face, happy with their performance, but still making it to the semifinals of a world championship. As we go back to the start once again, we had a start lead of 31 seconds for Sebastian Modin. Never paying attention to what was happening behind, just concentrating on his race. As he wins it here today, Oleg Ponomarev leaving his guide way behind, taking second place. Yuri Utkin disappointed, would have liked to qualify here, but it was not to be on this day. And now we'll go to our next semi-final, blind visually impaired, and Stanislav Chokolayev from Russia will take off first, B1. And there he goes, and he has a 31-second advantage on Nikolai Polukin and Vasily Shabsaboy from Belarus. And 5 seconds behind them will be Brian McKeever from Canada. So McKeever looking for a strong performance here, mentioning in some pre-race talks that he is looking for a good placing in this final preparation for the test event in Sochi and also for next year's Paralympic Games. McKeever, the Paralympic champion in Vancouver. Nikolai Polukin was the silver medalist. And Sebastian Modin, who's now qualified for the finals, had won bronze during that event. So here we go. Eric Carlton leading Brian McKeever out there. And right in front of them, we have Nikolai Polukin with his guide Andrei Tokarev. And also in this start, Stanislav Chokolayev with his guide Maxim Pirogov. And very tricky here. We see the hold section there as some of the athletes going down the hill, offering their pole to their guide, and keeping their safe distance in the descent. So now a beautiful battle here behind between Shapsiaboy and also right there, Nikolai Polukin. So these two guys battling it out, and the last to make it into the descent into the cross-country stadium below is Canadian Brian McKeever. Alors McKeever, champion paralympique de cette épreuve à Vancouver il y a 3 ans. Et oh, sorti! We have another skier going out. And is it Polukin? Is it Polukin? I think Polukin has gone off course. So, oh, that is hard for them. And now McKeever and Carlton really having to look out here as Nikolai Polukin, his adversary of McKeever, going off course. Oh, la, la, la. Only two spots available for the finals. And now Carlton and McKeever making their way around the bend now as Andrei Tokarev having to wait for Nikolai Polukin. second skier to go out there in that very sharp turn at the bottom of the course. But now focusing on the task at hand, Stanislav Choklaev from Russia. But breathing down his neck right now is Belarus's Vasily Shapsiaboy from Belarus. And coming now, the Paralympic champion, McKeever, with his guide, Eric Carlton. And Vasily Shapsiaboy has left Mihal Lebudziu, his guide, in his tracks. And concentrating now at the catching up, and that will happen in a few seconds, is Brian McKeever on Vasily Shapsiaboy, and it is going to be a two-up race now. As McKeever has not gone by Vasily Shapsiaboy yet. It's going to happen in a few seconds, but no pressure. They want to keep some energy in the gas tank, but they do have to be top two. Polukin not looking too bad either right now, as he is making his way back into the mix. McKeever just keeping his eyes set right now on his next prey, which is Vasily. Yes, and it's going to happen right now as we speak. There he is, going around him right now. Is Brian McKeever just passing Shapsiaboy as we speak, coming into the stadium. Palukin now going as hard as he can, trying to stay with McKeever. This would be an upset today if Nikolai Palukin does not make it into the finals. And it's a last ditch of effort. They have to get by Shapsiaboy to hope to sprint out, and it's gonna be Brian McKeever that is gonna make it in here. Yes, second, right behind him, Shapsiaboy and Polukin coming in what would be a disappointing third for him here today. And it probably, had it not been for that spill at the bottom there, could have been a two-up sprint for the finale. But Brian McKeever from Canada with Eric Carlton seeming very satisfied with the skis and their performance here today in this blind visually impaired semifinal heat number two. So we have our qualifiers. As for those of you watching on the web, we see the start here of our athletes, and already Choklaev having to deal with the presence of Shapsiaboy. No panic on the part of McKeever and Carlton as they saw one of their main rivals, Malukin, go out of tracks at the bottom. And McKeever not having to contend with Polukin in the final. Now back to the start for our next race, which is our women's final for blind and visually impaired. They are four at the start, getting ready for this final event for them here today. It's been a long road to this sprint final, qualifications, semis, and now into here, as we have our qualifiers now that are official on our results board in our men's visually impaired. So it'll be Sebastian Modin, Vasily Shapsiaboy, Brian McKeever, and Oleg Ponomarev in the men's blind and visually impaired final coming up very soon. But first, we're going to go to our ladies' final. And in this group, we'll have Elena Remizova, Mihalina Laisova, Yulia Budalieva, and Olga Prilutska from the Ukraine. So a very interesting race here for our ladies. And in that group are a silver medalist from the Paralympic Games in Vancouver, Mihalina Laisova, will be part of that group. Start. It was an event that was won by the great Verena Bentele from Germany. Many championships, I think over a dozen victories for her. So we're about 1 minute to start for the women's final. And my apologies, we are going to our... Yes, that is right, our women's visually impaired. That we changed a numbering system there, but no, it is the right ones. 91, Remizova, 92, Laisova, 93, Buralieva, and 94, Pilutska. Three Russians, one Ukrainian, and we're just about to start, and it will be all at the same time as they are all from the B2 class. 20 seconds to start. And there we are, the start of our women's blind visually impaired final. Who will it be? Elena Remizova, number 91. Mihalina Laisova, number 92. Yulia Budalieva, number 93 or 94 from the Ukraine. Olga Prilutska, who will be the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Champion, blind and visually impaired ladies class. And off to a fast-paced start. Mihailina Laisova, as we said, the silver medalist from the games in Vancouver 3 years ago already. My, time flies. And once again, the Russians out in force. They're looking for another medal here today. They've had a sweep in some categories, 1-2 in others. So it'll be very interesting what they'll be able to accomplish today here in the women's blind and visually impaired class. And it has started off with a bang as they are all three off the front. And coming up, bringing up the rear is Prilutska from the Ukraine. Now a slight lead here for Laisova. And she is the world champion from 2011. And a pole problem here for one of the Russian skiers. Is it Remizova? Yeah, it looks like her. So changing poles in the stadium. So looking to repeat her performance here today is once again Mihailina Laisova and her guide Alexei Ivanov. Right behind them, Elena Remizova and her guide Natalia Yakimova. So right here, an example of a skier that does relatively well in the short and middle distances and can still ski the long distances. Laisova has won the sprint event, as we mentioned, at the World Championships, gosh, a few years ago, and winning some 15 kilometers and 12.5 kilometer events in biathlon and in cross-country skiing. But right now, look at this. The surprise from this morning's qualifying and putting her move now on the leader is Elena Remizova. Remizova with the fastest time, almost 2 seconds faster than Laisova in the qualifying. And now Yulia Budalieva also in the mix. Good skis climbing very, very fast here as they are going to make their way back into the stadium. But the lead belonging to the world champ from 2011 and silver medalist from Vancouver, Mihalina Lysova. Elena Remizova making her way now into the stadium, having a good stab at things. More of a mid-distance to long-distance skier, changing maybe her training regimen as they make their way towards Sochi. It's Remizova. She's won three world championship events already, 5K, 15K in the relay, and in biathlon, a 7.5K world championship title and a bronze in the 3K pursuit. But this is going to be, once again, another repeat performance for a Russian in a world championship, as we have Mihalina Lysova coming towards the end here, making this one look easy almost, as she is in the final tracks for a world championship title in the women's blind and visually impaired class. Ladies and gentlemen, your world champion from Russia, Mihalina Lysova, and her guide, Alexei Ivanov. And rounding out here, the second spot, finally finishing with her guide, Natalia Yakimova, Elena Rimazova. And we will have another Russian sweep here, as in third place, we will have Yulia Budalieva garnering a bronze medal today. So 1, 2, 3, Russia in the women's blind and visually impaired sprint today in Solleftea, Sweden. And a good round of applause as she will be completing our blind and visually impaired women's group from the Ukraine, Olga Priluska. Mm-hmm. 1.125 kilometers here on some very difficult terrain in Solleftea. And we are going to get ready soon for our men's race, but before, for our web viewers, a replay of what happened here right off the start. Unfortunately for Yulia Budalieva, it is a trip up and a slip, and from that point on, Mihalina Lysova looked just towards the finish line, following her guide's instructions and concentrating on the win, making it look easy, and repeating her world championship performance from a few years ago at home is once again Mihalina Lysova of Russia. Russians putting a lot of time and effort and money into this program, as they will welcome the world next year for the Sochi Paralympic Games 2014. And many of these athletes will be representing their nations during those games in 1 year's time. Well, there's only one to go, my friends, and it is the men's blind and visually impaired final, as we will have quite a battle going on here. One skier will be missing that was part of the lot during the Paralympic Games, and that is Monsieur Bolukin, who unfortunately had a stroke of bad luck during the semis there, ending up off course. But we will see the bronze medalist from those games here today, Sebastian Modin from Zvaria, from Sweden, taking off. He'll be going head-to-head with Vasily Shapsiaboy, leaving 31 seconds after him. Brian McKeever, Paralympic champ, also taking the start, 36 seconds behind Modin. And Oleg Ponomarev from Russia will be leaving at the same time as Mr. McKeever. Alors voilà, McKeever pour le Canada. Ah, bonne posture pour se mériter possiblement une autre médaille en championnat du monde. Mais cette fois-ci, il aura nettement plus de travail alors que Modin semble en grande forme. So, Sebastian Modin was bronze medalist at the Paralympic Games. We'll see what he can do here at World Championships. McKeever and friends have their work cut out for them, as we saw from that semifinal. Modine in great form here at home in Sweden for these World Championships. So we're about 1 minute to the start. Une minute du départ. So for McKeever, a Paralympic game history garnered in gold and silver, winning his first gold medals in Salt Lake City in 2002. Picking up a couple of more golds in Torino, and three golds in the games at home in Vancouver. We're just about to start the men's final. Ten seconds to the start of Modine. Five, four, three, two, one, go. There we go. Sebastian Modine from Sweden. Will he be able to emulate the performance of Eleni Ripa, who won gold here at home? We will see. But he has some stiff competition behind him. Vasily Shapsiaboy from Belarus will be the next skier out. Then McKeever and Ponomarev will complete the start here. There goes Shatsiaboy for Belarus. And in 5 seconds, there go McKeever and Ponomarev. The hunt is now on. La chasse est commencée. Here we go. 1.125 kilometers. Will the Swede Sebastian Modine have it in him today with his guide, Albin Akkerud? We'll see, as now we also have on course the sprint champ from the Paralympic Games and also from the last World Championships, Mr. Brian McKeever on course. McKeever, one of the only Paralympians to take part in the Olympic Games, was selected, unfortunately for him, not making it to the playing field. However, has won many able-bodied competitions in his life. So there we go. The hostilities have started here today, and already McKeever picking up on Shapsiaboy. Ponomarev still in the mix here. Will they have it? And right now we saw Albin Akkerud looking behind him, making sure that Sebastian Modine was with him and going strong. But what they're also looking for is the red and white uniform of these two men here. And there they are, Eric Carlton, the guide for Brian McKeever. No panicking right now. It's all about timing and concentration. Alors McKeever en ce moment, qui remonte tout doucement sur Modine. But we saw what happened in the semis. Some of these skiers took Modine's lead a bit lightly, and it cost them because he just motored away and crossed the line in first. And he is looking for a world title here at home in Sweden. This is a historic battle going on here. And will Modine be able to keep this up, as he is now in contention? But here come the Canadians and also Belarus. Robin McKeever, the former guide for his brother Brian McKeever, on the sidelines there, giving the time gap to the Canadians. Carlton and McKeever going strong. McKeever stepping slightly out of the track there, having good skis. He is going to even blow away by Carlton, his guide. All he wants now is that top position. Brian McKeever, the battle between Canada and Zvaria now has started, as Sebastian Modine can now feel the presence and the passing of Brian McKeever. McKeever going for gold here today, as he has just passed Sebastian Modine. He is now in the lead. The man who has won this event at the World Championship level at the Paralympic Games and also looking to repeat his performance from 2 years ago at Worlds. What a beautiful ski here by Sebastian Molin of Sweden also. McKeever still preoccupied by Modine here as they come into the stadium around the last turn. It will be Canada's first medal here. And a second medal for Sweden today in this first day of competition of the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships. Here we go. It is Brian McKeever, Sebastian Modine. And I think it is still Shatsiaboy for Belarus behind, but they have lost some tracks. And there we go. World champion from Canada, du Canada, le champion du monde, Brian McKeever. And in second place, silver medal from Sweden, Svarias, Sebastian Morin. And Alvin Akerut, Eric Carlton joining McKeever. Congratulating Sebastian, and in third place, en troisième place, Vasily Shatsiaboy from Belarus and his guide, Mihal Lebedzu. Well, there we go, a second medal for Sweden, first medal for Canada here today at the IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships. Et voilà, mesdames et messieurs, la prestation. As we go back to our replay. For our web fans, Modine taking off with a 31-second advantage, followed by Shatsiaboy, who was 31 seconds behind. Then leading off were Ponomarev and McKeever. McKeever deciding on the last climb that it was time to attack, passing Modine and making his way here, repeating his performance from 2 years ago and from 3 years ago at the Paralympic Games. Brian McKeever, world champ of the sprint classic style race here today at the World Championships. Félicitations à Brian McKeever, champion du monde, ici au championnat du monde de Paranordique à Solleftea. So there we are, everybody. It is official. Brian McKeever, Sebastian Modine, and Oleg Ponomarev. Top three here today. So we'd like to say goodbye to our friends around the world on the World Wide Web. My name is Randy Ferguson. Thank you for being with us for these 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships live from Solleftea, Sweden. We invite you to be back tomorrow for our second day of action as we've had an amazing first day for all our friends here in Solleftea. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow for the continuation of the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships from Solleftea, Sweden.